looking at other types of wrist grab releases. The last video, we went up through here, you saw that. There'll be a link for it somewhere here so that you can see that. The other is to go to the outside. So we run the arms parallel. And we're always looking at the way the fingers articulate, how they open up. If you go in a manner where they close, it makes it easier for that person because they're not having to counter anything by engaging the nerves which fire the muscle to keep it closed against resistance. If you're actually going into where in the same direction they're going, it helps them a lot. It's the same way as when you've got somebody in a headlock and that type of a control, you're starting to go there. If you turn into my body, then it makes it easier for me versus working to control that arm, head up, hips out, spinning to the back, things like that, which we'll cover if you're interested. So in this particular case, we get pulled like this. I'm going to raise it just to the level of my waist before I start turning parallel to them in the same plane. The reason that I do that is I want to start getting this cover to here. Remember, everything that we do can be preceded by a pop in the eyes, pop in the throat, that sort of thing. Getting some sort of response on this side to help alleviate the pressure that's on here. If they're pulling and they're pulling with, I can just step outside just as well. And when you run your arms parallel to what they're doing, again, it's not an expected thing. It's not something that people generally do. A couple of ways we can play with this is one, I'm just going to go through here. If I get up underneath, I'll pull this here and I'll work this into a strike. I can pull down here on the arm and drag her out. Okay. The other is I can go through here if I'm up on top. This is more rebel Wing Chun. This is what we do. Feed this into here. I've got this same strike, and if I want to, I hook on the top and pull the arm out and work the person in that regard. So again, these are just two that we work as a matter of getting out of somebody who's trying to control. The structure of the wrist, even on a very strong person, if their fingers close all the way around, like mine close here, and I'm not weak in the grip. So if she's actually going out, I'm gonna actually clamp down pretty hard, and she's just gonna run parallel. There we go. If I maintain that grip, it's gonna start putting me in a lock. It's gonna start tearing some things over time. So I wanna make sure that as I work, there we go. So even under that type of pressure, she can still get out. And this is something that you have to think about, is that stepping. Where are you going to go after that? If I'm in here, this control is a strike to the gut as I slip this out. So look at this for a second. I'm coming up here. My head is coming into my hands, my cover. I'm working that motion either up on top or on the bottom. A taller person against a smaller person. So if I'm in like this, her benefit is to go underneath because that's easier for her to work. A lot of people will try to go over the top. The ego comes into play on that. And this is not good for her. So if she does that, just the fact that she's doing this, I mean, puts her off base. Anytime you start raising the arms over the top of your balance system, what happens is you get great leverage for your opponent. So shorter people, stay lower. Work the low line. It's not as glamorous. It's not these great shots, you know, that sort of thing, but stay low, use your center of gravity, and use the mechanical function of your body that is already there. Don't try to reach up. That's the problem with a lot of shorter people, is they want to reach up. They want to punch up. They want to do all sorts of things which you look at on the outside and say, why is this person doing that? You want to stay with your physical, mechanical range of motion and your center of gravity. If you start raising your center of gravity to reach somebody up there, that means your base is going to be compromised a lot easier. So own your range, own your height. Be proud of that. That's what you got. You can function within that against resisting opponents really well if you don't try to be something else. So in here, again, I'm working. I open this up. This is stepping in. And my step and my elbow should land almost at the same time. This is a squatting position. I don't want to be up really high and trying to do this. Yeah, because she'll automatically feel that. I sink down, she tries to do that. Ah, it goes right to here. It goes up, it goes right here. It's really easy. If you look at the physics of that, my position, if I'm up here, again, I'm elevating myself up so her lever system is much better. And now we have this contact point, so she's gonna brace off of that. So even if I'm trying to force that in there, it's not gonna work. But I sit down here, all of a sudden that immediately gets transferred there. My base is set. The other end, when I'm coming through here, you have the option of going up into the face, especially if their arms are long and you can get up underneath here. You can also strike up underneath the armpit. There's a lot of nerves and artery pathways that go underneath the armpit. So when you're going through here and you strike that hard with a pull, that's damaging. Not to mention the ribs. Right here, you get a nice, you end up turning the person because of the pull and your step, and you slam into the ribs. If you haven't had cracked ribs before or broken ribs before, you really don't understand the length of recovery period. You can't sleep, you can't find a position to sit in, to relax, you can't lay a certain way. You can't sneeze, cough, you can't be around people who are trying to make you laugh, that sort of thing, because that's all agony for a very long period of time. They take a lot to heal. So if I'm in here like this, we've got all those as options. If this fails because she's got some skill like that, I turn this into the takedown. Now, if I'm gonna go sapu again, I'm gonna go with that mentality, I can do it two ways. I can go here, turn her out this way, and pull, which is more in line with the actual sapu movement, or I do the hook and pull her. It goes fast, as you saw. It's a bit unexpected. Now, if I'm on top and I go through here, we strike here, same position. I can go across the face, similar to what we did in the last video, and I can sapu and sweep out here, or do the hook on the top and pull the arm down. That can be done independently of the sweep or in addition to the sweep. So when I'm in here like this, I've tried this, she's blocked it, boom. These two will go and take her down. If you enjoyed what you saw, let me know by hitting the thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't subscribed. It really helps grow our channel. And again, there's a notification bell. Tap that. That also alerts you every time that I upload a new video. You get notified right off the bat. If you have comments or questions or even requests, I know I've got a bunch of requests. I'm going to do another video with viewer questions, and I'm going to address a lot of those, so your chances are your questions will be answered, or at least some of those who've already in the queue. I'm going to answer them in the next video, in one of the upcoming videos. If you have some requests that you would like to see, some escape, some type of control, or if you have a problem in your own training and you can't find a way to work around it, shoot me a line. Put it down there in the comments below, or even at CoreJKD.com. Go in the comment, the contact page there. Send me an email. And if it's personal, because I know some of you send personal information, which I don't post up for the rest of the people to see, I respect that. And I do also appreciate you revealing stuff to me that's important to you. And if you need help, If there's something that you think I can give you a different perspective on, that's what I'm here for. Thank you.